절 말씀을 교독을 하도록 하겠습니다.
We'll have responsive reading.
예수께서 이 말씀을 하시고 제자들과 함께 기드론 시내 건너편으로 나가시니 그곳에 동산이 있는데 제자들과 함께 들어가시니라.
Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, for Jesus often met there with his disciples.
유다가 군대와 대제사장들과 바리새인들에게서 얻은 아랫 사람들을 데리고 등과 횃불과 무기를 가지고 거리로 오는지라.
Then Jesus, knowing all that would happen to him, came forward and said to them, "Whom do you seek?"
대답하되 나사렛 예수라 하거늘 이르시되 내가 그니라 하시니라. 그를 파는 유다도 그들과 함께 섰더라.
When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they drew back and fell to the ground.
이에 다시 누구를 찾느냐고 물으신데 그들이 말하되 나사렛 예수라 하거늘.
Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he, so if you seek me, let these men go."
이는 아버지께서 내게 주신 자 중에서 하나도 잃지 아니하였사옵나이다 하신 말씀을 응하게 하려 함이니라.
Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's servants and cut off his right ear. The servant's name was Malichus. So Jesus said
이르시되,
to Peter, "Put your sword into his sheath. Shall I not drink the cup that the Father has given me?"
하시니라.
Amen.
축복을 선언하겠습니다. 평안하십시오.
Let us bless each other. Be at peace.
당신은 세계 살릴 선교사입니다.
You're the missionaries to save the world.
그 황무한 땅을 기업으로 누리십시다.
Let us receive the inheritance of the desolate heritages.
오늘 일부 찬양대 너무 은혜로운 찬양 감사합니다.
The first worship choir, thank you for your graceful praise.
또 이 곡이 이렇게 불려질 수 있구나 새로운 은혜를 받게 되었습니다.
And I was able to receive grace that oh this praise could be sung this way.
주 예수보다 더 귀한 분은 없습니다.
It's right. There is no one that's more precious than Jesus Christ.
오직 예수밖에만 있을 뿐입니다.
Only there is only Jesus.
오직 예수 그리스도로 충만한 시간들 되기를 주의 이름으로
축원합니다. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May today be the time where you are filled by Jesus Christ.
여러분 기도해 주셔서 두 주간 미주 대학 수련회와 캐나다 렘넌트에 은혜 받고 또 돌아올 수 있어서 감사했습니다.
And because of your prayers, I was able to go to America and to Canada and finish the retreats there and come back.
우리 장로님 기도하셨던 것처럼 초강대국 속에 하나님이 하시는 일을 보는 그런 시간표였습니다.
Just as the elder prayed, it was a time schedule where I was able to see the field of the powerful nations.
하나님의 나라가 필요한 이유들을 새롭게 붙잡게 되는 그런 시간들이었습니다.
And it was a time where I was able to hold on to that even though they are the powerful nations, they need the word of God.
사실 미국도 복음이 희미해지고 복음이 사라지고 있고요.
Even America, the gospel is becoming dim and the gospel is disappearing.
캐나다 현장도 마찬가지였습니다.
And it was same for the fields in Canada.
미주 대학 수련회가 스미스 장로교회에서 진행이 되어졌었습니다.
The University of Students for the retreat. It took place in the Summit Summit Church, and they were able to buy that church anew.
지금 세워진 지 한 60년, 70년 정도 되어가는 교회였습니다.
It's a church that was built for 60 years.
그 교회의 시작이 2차 세계 대전 때의 남편들을 전쟁터에 보내고 부인들이 기도하면서 세워진 교회가 그 교회였습니다.
And it was a church where it was raised up when the wives was so sent off their husbands to war and in prayer built this church.
선포되지 않으니까 시간 가면 갈수록 교회가 약해질 수밖에 없는 것이고요.
But because the gospel was not becoming relayed, that is why the church grew weaker.
교회 운영이 안 되어지니까 결국 교회를 매물로 내어 놓았던 것입니다.
And they were not able to run the church. That is why they just put it on for sale.
예전에 에덴 장로교회였는데 그 교회가 사들여서 지금 이름을 바꿨습니다. 장로교회로 해서 지금 교회 예배를 드리고 있는 것입니다.
The church name was the Eden Elders Church, but it changed to Summit Elders Church.
많은 미주에 있는 대학생들이 함께 참여하게 되었고.
And many other university students of America attended this conference. And many other professors who used to be remnants came together and gave worship. And after that, we had the Canada conference.
보니까 뭔가 길거리마다 너무나 지저분하고요.
In Canada, in the street by street, they were very dirty. And I was able to see that spiritually, they were also dark.
할 수 있는 곳인데 다민족이 들어와서 나라의 주를 이루고 있고요.
The multi-ethnics has come into that nation.
거기에서 일어나는 마약과 동성애 이런 많은 문제들을 갖고 있는 것을 보게 됩니다.
And you're able to see there are many problems regarding homosexuality and drugs.
그 기간은 캐나다의 국경일이에요. 캐나다 공휴일로 캐나다 데이를 해서 모든
So they had this Canada Day.
쉬는 시간들이었어요.
And it was a time where everybody who lived in Canada rested from work.
그 쉬는 시간에 진행되는 것은 동성애 축제들이 길거리마다 진행되고 있는 것을 보았습니다.
But what took place on that on those holidays was the homosexual festivals that arose. And there were flags regarding the homosexuals.
저희들이 집회가 진행되어진 교회도 사실은 교회 마당에 들었으니까 동성애 표시가 되어 있어요.
And even in some of the churches, they also had this flag.
안에는 십자가가 걸려 있습니다.
So thinking, is this a church? And we went inside, and there was a cross inside.
모든 종교에서 좋은 말들 다 모아가지고 문을 만들어 놓았고.
But they made all of the good words and combined it together, and they placed it inside of the church.
아예 동성애들이 이용할 수 있는 화장실로 만들어 놓은 것을 보게 됩니다.
And you can able to see that there was a bathroom that was made for the homosexuals. In one word, there is no gospel. And that is why there is no choice but for disasters to occur. But you're able to see that God is still doing His work. And what is the work of God?
복음 없어서 재앙 가운데 빠지는 민족들을 그냥 내버려 두지 않으시고 그 민족을 회복하기 위해서 복음 가진 렘넌트들을 하나님께서 일으키시고 계시는 것을 보게 됩니다.
He hasn't just discarded that nation, but to save that nation, God has prepared the remnants and is raising up the remnants. As I was traveling along, I was able to feel this. It was same for America and same for Canada. And as I went to Hong Kong and Europe, I felt the same way.
후대 렘넌트들이 각기 있는 현장에서 말씀의 인도를 받으면서 제자로 세워지는 부분들을 보게 되었습니다.
I was able to see the remnants in the, each of the fields holding on to the gospel and being raised up as a disciple. And I was able to realize, oh, the plan of God is not a disaster.
남은 자 렘넌트를 일으켜서 그 재앙에
God will raise up the remnants with the gospel as those who remain and to save the disaster field, that is the plan of God. I was able to realize. And realistically, many other remnants are arising right now. And the same for Canada. This one family came to meet me, counsel with me. And they went to Seoul University. And is working in this very renowned place. And as he was, as we were having a conversation, this is what they said.
교회에서 지금 많은 그 먼 거리 떨어져 있기 때문에 교회 예배에 참여할 수는 없다.
Because they're so far away from the church, that is why they cannot come to church to give worship.
나오는 본부의 흐름 강단 메시지는 놓치지 않고 있다.
But inside of their fields, they're not losing hold of the stream of the words that are coming out of the headquarters.
그분이 간절한 마음으로 부탁을 했어.
But with an earnest heart, he asked me a favor.
영상을 통해서 나오는 본부 말씀을 가지고 인도를 받지만 우리 아이들이 말씀 받을 데가 없다고.
Though they are receiving the words from through the media, but
어린 아이들이 세 명이었어요.
He had three children, but the children had no place to go.
되는데, 그 메시지를 들을 수 있는 곳이 없다라고.
They had to listen to the message in English, but they had no place to listen to the message. And that is why he, with an earnest heart, he asked and asked that if you could send off the English message. And I heard that as the voice of God. And I think this is the hearts for all of the people. To our prosperities, our remnants, the accurate gospel must be proclaimed so that they can save that age.
이번에 그 세계 리더와 세계 렘넌트에 놓고 우리 장로님들 중심에서 교회가 한 마음으로 기도하고 있습니다.
And right now the elders are gathering together in one heart praying for the WRC and the leaders retreat, and after that we will have the Hana Remnant Conference. And for that, truly pray.
영원한 기업, 영원한 작품, 영원한 유산을 바르게 전달할 수 있는 교회가 될 수 있도록 기도해 주시길 바랍니다.
And truly pray for our church so that our church could become the church where we relay the eternal inheritance, eternal portion.
문제를 해결할 수 있는 귀중한 답입니다.
And the eternal legacy.
렘넌트들이 이제는 일어나서 교회의 중요한 자리 속에서 귀한 일에 심부름하고 있는 것을 보게 됩니다.
And for that, you're able to see many other people running their errands.
모든 흩어진 현장에서 하나님의 일이 무엇입니까?
So inside of the fields that are scattered, what is the work of God? Jesus Christ is doing the works pertaining to the kingdom of God. And that is the work of God, where God is raising up the remnants in the scattered fields. And to raise up those remnants, God has called us. And that itself is a blessing.
정말 우리가 조그만 헌신과 기도와 물질 들여서 우리 후대를 위해서
with the little devotion and prayer and the offerings that we give, our prosperities are being raised up.
한 시대를 살릴 렘넌트로 자라난다면 그만큼 축복된 일이 있을 수가 없는 것입니다.
And if the remnants hold on to that as their footstool and stand up and become the summit, there is no other greater works than that. So truly continue to pray. And during the college retreat in America, very important word was given, and there was the three things that we must discover. All of the remnants must raise up the partisan of prayer inside of your families.
제일 불평하고 또 어떤 면에 원망하고 있는 것이 있다면은 배경인 가정의 배경입니다.
What the remnants are always complaining and grumbling about is the background of their families.
물론 나쁜 것은 아니지만 많은 렘넌트들이 가정의 상처들을 가지고 있습니다.
It's not also always the case, but many of the remnants have scars regarding their families.
이제는 가정의 상처에 머물러 있을 것이 아니라 오히려 그 가정 속에서 기도 제목들을 발견하고 가문을 통해서 기도 제목들을 발견하고 기도의 망대를 세워 나갈 것을 말씀하셨습니다.
But they must not reside in the scars of their families, but they must find the prayer topics and raise up the prayer partisan inside of their families. And they must also prepare the future partisan. And with the power that is given from above, they must prepare the partisan of the field. And it was a great answer that was given to the remnants. Everybody has the problems of their families and family line, and also the education, and they face problems inside of the field. But how can we have victory inside of that? That answer was given. And during the conference that took place in Canada, a very important answer was given. And the remnants themselves are the inheritance. So they must become the main figures for the Holy Meditation Movement. and they must challenge.
렘넌트 응답을 놓고 하급들을 작품으로 만들라고 했습니다.
And with the answers of the top remnant, they must
conquer the education. 빛의 경제를 회복하라 말씀했습니다.
And they must restore the finance of the economy of light. And this is what we must leave behind.
캐나다 현장을 위해서 선포된 메시지입니다만은 우리 모든 후대들이 또 우리 또한 붙잡아야 될 귀중한 메시지입니다.
This was a message that was given inside of America and Canada, but this is the word that we also must hold on to. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May precious remnants be risen up. And today's title is Jesus Christ who has done the works pertaining to the kingdom of God. For us, what is the greatest work that we must do? What is the greatest thing that we must enjoy as we live on this land? And that is the grace and the love of God. We were created in the image of God. And we are a being where we must absolutely rely on God. And we were the being where we were truly happy inside of the grace and the love of God. And having the relationship with God, we were able to be happy and enjoy. And God has given us the word as the method so that we can enjoy the created world and God. God has given us the word so that we can enjoy the grace and the love of God. In Genesis 2:7, He has given us the breath of life. And in Genesis 2:17, He has given us the covenant of knowledge of good and evil.
그 말씀을 지키고 붙잡는 자가 하나님을 누리도록 하신 것이 하나님의 창조의 원리인 것입니다.
So those who know the word of God and the covenant of God, they were able to enjoy God, and that was the principle of creation. But being deceived by Satan's word that was of temptation, they listened to the word of the serpent, which was Satan. So they were placed in two decisions. Are they going to follow after the word of God, or are they going to follow after the word of Satan?
But
in the end, you are able to see that Adam and Eve, they chose the word of Satan over the word of God because of their disobedience and unbelief. And that is why curses and disasters befell mankind. And our status changed into the children of Satan. Because we are cut off from God and we are now child of the devil, disasters and curses have no choice to come to us, and they're no longer able to receive the love and the grace of God. But God, through the Word, has given us the way so that we can be saved. Genesis 3:15, the offspring of woman will crush the head of the serpent. And that is the way for us to live.
3장 18절에 희생제사의 언약을 통해서 이스라엘 백성들을 출애굽시킬 것을 약속하셨습니다.
And Exodus 3:18, through the sacrificial offering, God has promised the Israelites that they will come out of Egypt.
임마누엘의 언약을 이사야 7장 14절에 주셨습니다.
And Isaiah 7:14 has given us the covenant where we are where the Israelites could be set free from being the captives of Babylon. Therefore the Lord himself will give to you a sign. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall call his name Emmanuel. And when they were colonized by Rome, through the covenant of Christ, that they will be saved, that was promised to the Israelites. And the one that confessed that was Peter. Matthew 16:16. Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And those who hold on to the covenant of God and to those who enter inside of that covenant, God gives His grace and love to them. And the spiritual status changed to the children of God and have become the person who can receive the answers. And to us who have received salvation through the name of Jesus Christ, what we need today, it is the grace and the love of God. If you have received salvation, then God will lead us, the children of God, with His love and grace.
어떠한 인도하심으로 나타나는 것인가를 생각하면서 참된 감사를 해보가는 축복의 시간들 되기를 주의 이름으로
축복합니다. I bless you in the name of the Lord. In this day, may you receive the greatest grace and the love of God.
이 구원의 사역을 위해서 예수 그리스도께서 이 땅에 오셨습니다.
And in today's
그리고 오늘 본문에는 그 예수 그리스도께서
passage
잡히신 모습이
Jesus Christ has come
나오고 있는 것입니다.
As our Savior. But in today's passage, he was captured. But if you see in today's passage, you are able to see those who lived for themselves. So you are able to see Judas the Iscariot who lived for his own benefits. If you see in verses 1 through 7, today you are able to see. You know that so well that Judas Iscariot, he was one of the disciples. And he was very quick on his calculations. And he was in charge of all of the finances. But for his own benefit, he even stole money and used it. And if you see in John 12:4-6, you're able to see. And Jesus went into this one region. And that was the place where Lazarus was raised up.
But Mary's sister comes to the presence of Jesus at the wedding.
And there, pours out
발을 닦게 됩니다.
This fragrance to
그
on the feet of Jesus, and seeing that Judas Iscariot said, "So,
그것을 가난한 자들에게 주는 것이 좋지 않겠느냐?"
Why was this ointment not sold for 300 denarii and given to the poor?
성경에서 답을 말하고 있습니다. 도둑이라 했습니다. 돈깨를 맞고 그게
있는 것을
도둑이 바로 가룟 유다였습니다.
That Jesus Iscariot, he was a thief.
결국 이 유다는 자기의 이익을 위해서 예수님을 은 30에 대제사장과 장로들에게 넘겨주기로 약속하셨던 것입니다.
And you're able to see that Judas Iscariot, for his own benefit, sold Jesus for 30 silvers.
결국은 유다는 군대와 무리를 이끌고 무기를 가지고 예수를 잡기 위해서 오게 되었다라고 3절에 말씀하고 있는 것입니다.
In today's passage, verse 3, you're able to see that Judas, he brought the band of soldiers and some officers
사람이 바로 가룟 유다였어요.
And weapons to capture Jesus.
마태복음 27장에 보면은 결국 자신의 잘못을 인정하고 결국 자살하게 됨으로 비참한 생애로 인생이 끝나는 것을 보게 됩니다.
But if you see Matthew 27, you are able to see that he has come to the realization of his wrongdoings and commits suicide.
그리고 4절 5절에 보면 내가 무지한 피를 팔고 죄를 범하였다라고
He's saying I have sinned by betraying innocent blood.
그리고 결국은 자살하게 된 것을 보게 됩니다.
And he killed himself.
여러분 가룟 유다는 예수님이 그리스도이심을 믿지 못했습니다.
Judas Iscariot, he could not believe that Jesus was Christ.
예수님 제자로 가장 가까이 있었던 사람입니다.
But he was the disciple that was closest to Jesus.
그러나 예수님을 그리스도로 믿지 못함으로 말미암아
But because he could not believe that Jesus is Christ,
이용당한 사람이 바로 가룟 유다.
He was used by Satan for the work of Satan.
그래서 요한복음 13장 2절에 보면 말씀하고 있습니다.
And in John 13:2.
마귀가 벌써 시몬 아들 가룟 유다의 마음에
During supper, when the devil had already put it into the heart of Judas Iscariot, Simon's son, to betray him,
자신의 이익을 위해서 살려고 했던 가룟 유다 사단이 이용한 것입니다.
Judas Iscariot, who wanted to live for his own benefits, Satan used him. And you're able to see that his life ended in a bad way.
예수가 그리스도이심을 답을 내리지 못한다면은 우리의 모든 모습들이 어떻든 자신의 이익을 중심으로 살아갈 수밖에 없는 모습들인 것을 아세요.
You must know that if we do not know that Jesus is Christ and we are not able to believe that, then we are going to live for our own benefits.
인간의 생각을 따라 판단한 사람들이 나옵니다.
And there are people, they thought and made judgments with their own thoughts. Judas Iscariot sold Jesus for his own benefits. And there's a person that came out who judged according to the thoughts of people. And if you see in verse 12, you're able to see Annas and Caiaphas.
사실은 안나스와 가야바는 장인과 사위 사이입니다.
So Annas and Caiaphas.
근데 안나스는
so Caiaphas was
대제사장으로서 직에서 현직에서 물러난 사람이고.
Annas was the father-in-law of Caiaphas.
그 뒤를 이은 사람이 사위인 가야바입니다.
So he was a high priest and later on Caiaphas received that high priest.
대제사장은 어떤 사람입니까?
So who is the high priest?
하나님의 말씀과 은혜를 알고 말을 지나는 사람들이 바로 대제사장들입니다.
High priests are the people who know the grace of God and relay the word of God.
속죄 일을 대신해서 맡은 사람들이 바로 대제사장들입니다.
And they give this blood sacrifice for other people's sin.
기다리는 사람들이 바로 대제사장들이었습니다.
They are the people who are awaiting the coming of Christ.
오늘 본문에 나오는 가야바 바로 또 안나스는 대제사장이면서 예수를 진짜 그리스도인 것을 믿지 못했기 때문에 오히려 죽이려고 했던 것을 보게 됩니다.
But you're able to see Annas and Caiaphas, they were not able to believe that Jesus is Christ and they tried to kill Jesus. They're not able to find any wrongdoings of Jesus.
자신들이 생각하는 메시아가 예수님이 될 수 없다라고 생각을 했습니다.
But they had the thought that the Jesus cannot become the Messiah that they were thinking of.
하려고 했던 것이 바로 31절에 나오고 있습니다.
And they were able to get rid of Jesus. If you see in verse 31.
말씀에 가까이 있다고 생각하는 사람들이었어요.
They were the people who thought to themselves that they were the closest to the word of God.
가장 하나님을 잘못 이해한 사람이 누구냐? 바로 대제사장인 안나스와 가야바였습니다.
But they were the people who were not able to realize the word of God, and that was Annas and Caiaphas, the high priest. We must believe in the word of God.
우리의 경험과 우리의 생각과 우리의 기준을 쫓아가는 신앙이 되어서는 아니 되는 것입니다.
We must not live the walk of faith where we chase after our own experiences and thoughts.
마지막 때 엄청난 고통의 때가 온다고 말씀했습니다.
In the end, there will be great disaster.
왜 고통의 때가 오느냐라고 디모데후서
There will be an age of pain. Why is it tell us that?
이렇게 말씀하고 있습니다. 때가 이르느니 사람들이 바른 교훈을 받지 아니할 것이다 했어요. 귀가 가려워서 자기의 사욕을 따를 스승을 많이 둔다 했어요.
If you see in
또 그 길을 진리에서 돌이켜
Timothy,
허탄한
chapter
이야기를
3.
쫓으리라 했어요.
But understand this, that in the last days there will come times of difficulties for people will be lovers of self, lovers of money, proud, arrogant, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy. So if you do not follow after the word of God, this is what's going to happen. And if you see in today's passage, verse 28 through 40, you're able to see people who follow after the popular opinions of people. And that was the Pilate.
빌라도는 예수님과의 대화를 통해서 예수님이 죄 없는 분인 것을 알았습니다.
Pilate knew that having a conversation with Jesus, that Jesus had no sin.
여론과 분위기를 따라서 예수님을 결국은 십자가에 못 박는 자리에 내어놓게 되었습니다.
But because of the popular opinions and because of the atmosphere of the Jewish people, he had no choice but to place Jesus and crucify him.
바로 여론 아닙니까?
But if you see the people who are in the
말들에 대해서 가장 관심 있습니다.
Politics, politicians, they follow after the popular opinions.
총독으로서 예수님이 죄였음을 알면서도 여론과 분위기를 의식해서 예수님을 십자가에 못 박는 자리에 내어놓게 된 것입니다.
And it was seen for Pontius Pilate, who was following after the popular opinions of the many people.
성경 신앙 고백할 때마다 본디오 빌라도에게 고난을 받으사 늘 고백하잖아요.
And even today, we give the confession that
여론과 분위기 속에 속아서 결국은 예수님을 죽는 자리에
Pontius Pilate crucified Jesus Christ. And he followed after the popular opinions.
사실이 아닌 것들을 사실로 생각하고 살아가는 사람들이 많이 있습니다.
And many people follow after the popular opinions.
사람이 두 사람 모여도 여론이 만들어집니다.
If there's just two people, popular opinions are made. We must not follow after the popular opinions.
그리스도의 말씀이어야 합니다.
Our only standard must be the Jesus Christ, the Word of God.
14장에 보면은 가나안 땅을 정탐꾼들이 정탐하고 돌아왔습니다.
And if you see in the book of Numbers, the spies go in and see the land of Canaan.
여론의 말을 들었어 그래.
And they were lamenting day and night.
대책을 세우자 대책을 세웠습니다.
Because they followed after the popular opinions.
애굽으로 다시 돌아가자라고 이야기했습니다.
And that is why all of the people, the Israelites, said, "Let's raise up a new leader and go back to Egypt."
많은 부분에 실수하게 되고.
So following after the popular opinions, we make mistakes and we make wrong decisions.
교회 안에도 여러분 말들이 이런 말 저런 말들 많은 말들이 있을 수 있습니다.
And even inside of the church, there could be many words.
당연한 것이 사람들이 모여서 사람의 말들을 할 수밖에 없으니까요.
Because people gather and they have no choice but to speak of the word of people.
잘 듣고 잘 분별하고 잘 판단해야 합니다.
Well, we must be able to listen to it carefully and we must be able to decipher it carefully. And if you see in the book of Isaiah, there are seven churches. But inside of the seven churches, there's
a
thing that's in common.
우리의 생각 따라 말씀을 받지 마시고요.
We must not follow after the word of people.
이 사실을 붙잡는 것이 우리의 신앙의 기준이 되어야 합니다.
We must heed to the word of God and
그렇지 않으면 우리도
follow after the word of God and having that as our standards. But because we're not able to, we are always hindered. So our standard must only become the Word of God. And through the Word, we must be able to confirm inside of our lives. Why is that? Because the method of God working is through the Word. And how God gives us the answer is through the Word. And so holding on to the Word itself, it is receiving
answers.
We must be able to always ask God, what is the word that you are trying to give us today? Why is that? If you see in the book of Psalms, Psalms 119:105, your word is the lamp of my feet and the light to my path. That is why we must always hold on to the word of God.
안나스와 또 가야바, 빌라도 또한 가룟 유다에 대한 모습들을 우리가 살펴보았습니다.
So we are able to see that people who live for themselves, Judas the Iscariot, Annas, Caiaphas, and Pilate. But we haven't read today, but in the passage, there's Peter.
25절 27절에 보면은 베드로와 겁이 나서 세 번이나 부인했던 모습들이 나오죠.
And you're able to see that Peter, because he was afraid, he
13장에 보면 이미 예수님께서 베드로가 부인할 것을 예언하셨습니다.
But Jesus already
had prophesied. 그런데 오늘 본문에 보면 15절 17절에 움직이는 여종 앞에서 부인하게 되고요.
And so in front of the servant girl, Peter
25절에 27절에 refuses Jesus. 사람들 앞에서 부인하게 되고요.
And in front of the people, he refuses Jesus.
그리고 27절 마지막 보면 대제사장의 종이 예수님과 함께 있는 것을 보았다고 했을 때도 부인함으로 세 번째 부인하는 것을 보게 됩니다.
And you're able to see he denied again. When the roosters crowed.
베드로는 누굽니까?
Who's Peter? He was the disciple of Jesus.
유일한 그리스도를 고백한 사람이었습니다.
He was the one person that confessed that Jesus is Christ. Matthew 16:16.
다시는 절대로 예수님 죽는 자리에 내려놓지 않겠다라고 요한복음 13장 37절에 이야기했던 사람이었습니다.
And he was the person that in John 13:37 that he will not allow anyone to kill Jesus.
혼 장담했던 사람이 바로 베드로였습니다.
And he was so sure that he will protect Jesus.
37절에 뭐라고 말씀했는가요?
What does it say in John 13:37?
주를 위하여 내 목숨을 버리겠나이다.
Peter said to him, Lord, why can I follow you? Now I will lay down my life for you. But that Peter denied Jesus three times.
눈에 보이는 위협으로 말미암아 두려움이 생겨서 부인하게 된 것입니다.
Because of the threat that was seen, he was because of his fear, he denied. It wasn't because that he did not believe that Jesus was Christ. It was just because of the things that was seen in his eyes, he denied Jesus. And Jesus came to Peter, who denied him, and he asked him. Peter,
21장에 나오는 말씀이죠.
Do you love me?
베드로가 뭐라고 고백합니까?
And what does Peter say?
주여 그러하여이다. 내가 주님을 사랑하는지 주께서 아시나이다.
It says
주님께서 세 번이나 물으시면 세 번이나 대답하셨습니다.
He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." And at the end, he says,
"베드로는 그
feed
이후로
my lamb."
예수님과 복음을 위해서 목숨을 바치고 순교한 사람이었습니다.
And later on, he was able to be martyred for the word of God.
예수님 앞에 순교한 사람이 바로 베드로였던 사실을 우리에게 보여주고 있습니다.
You're able to see that Peter goes and he was martyred for Jesus Christ.
잠시의 두려움으로 예수님을 부인했지만요.
Just because of the fear, he denied Jesus.
예수님이 그리스도심을 믿었고요.
But he believed that Jesus was Christ.
그것을 위해서 전 인생을 드린 전도자였던 것을 우리에게 보여주고 있는 것입니다.
And he was able to become the evangelist to save the world.
예수가 그리스도심을 믿으며 저와 여러분의 인생이 복음과 그리스도를 위해서 정말로 모든 것들을 드릴 수 있는 전도자의 삶이 되기를 주의 이름으로 축원합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you believe in that Jesus is Christ and live the life of an evangelist. Conclusion.
오늘 마지막 부분에 보면 하나님 나라의 일을 예수님께서 말씀하셨습니다.
In the end, you're able to see the works pertaining to the kingdom of God. John 18:36 says,
내 나라는 이 세상에 속한 것이 아니다.
It says, my kingdom is not of this world.
내 나라는 여기에 속한 것이 아니다라고 36절 마지막에 말씀하고 있습니다.
And in the end, he says that, but my kingdom
그렇습니다.
is not from the world.
속하지 않은 것이 바로 하나님의 나라인 것.
The kingdom of God. Is
그래서 육신적인 싸움을 할 필요가 없습니다.
Of this world, so we no longer have to have a physical fight.
이 세상의 문제를 해결하려고 하는 것입니다.
But because we do not know the works of the kingdom of God, we keep having a physical fight.
자들에게 임하는 것이 바로 하나님의 나라입니다.
But the kingdom of God is established to those who believe.
하나님의 나라는 성령의 임재 속에서 흑암의 권세를 무너지게 하는 것이 바로 하나님의 나라인 것입니다.
And the kingdom of God is established and the Holy Spirit dwells inside of us and the forces of darkness is broken down. Matthew 12:28. But if it is by the Spirit of God that I cast out demons, then the kingdom of God has come upon you.
예수님이 이 나라를 위해서 이 나라의 왕으로 오셨습니다.
And he has come as the king of this world.
왕이신 예수 그리스도에 대한 부분들이 37절에 나옵니다.
And if you see in verse 37, you're able to see
빌라도가 묻습니다.
Pilate said to him, "So you are the king?"
대답하십니다.
Jesus answered,
네 말과 같이 내가 왕이다라고 말씀했.
You say that I am a king for this
예수님이
purpose.
예수님이 하나님 나라의 왕이 되십니다.
Jesus is the king, and for that he was born, and for that he has come into the world.
왕의 일을 하신 것입니다.
He has done the work of the king in this land.
14절 15절에 말씀하고 있습니다.
And in Hebrews 2:14-15,
죽음을 통하여 죽음의 권세를 잡은 자 마귀를 멸하시며
through death he might destroy the one
또 죽기를 무서워함으로 한 평생 되어 존귀로라는 자들을 놓아주려 하심이라
and deliver all those who through fear of death were subject to lifelong slavery.
죽음을 통하여 죽음의 세력을 잡은 자 마귀를 멸하셨다 말씀했어요.
So he has come to destroy the work of the devil who holds on to the authority of death.
죄를 짓는 자는 마귀에게 속한다 했습니다. 마귀는 처음부터 범죄함이었다
말씀했어요. And in 1 John 3:8 it says whoever makes a practice of sinning is of the devil for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The reason the son of God appeared was to destroy the works of the devil.
무너뜨린 사단의 왕됨을 무너뜨린 참된 왕 중의 왕이 바로 그리스도인 것입니다.
He is the king of all kings who has done the work of destroying the work of the devil. In Acts 10:38,
모든 사람을 고치셨다 말씀했어요.
He said healing all who were oppressed by the devil.
나귀에게 눌린 모든 사람을 고치셨다 말씀했어요.
So he healed all those people who were oppressed by the devil.
참된 왕으로 오신 그리스도가 여러분 인생의 주인 되기를 바랍니다.
So I really hope that the Jesus Christ who has come as the King of all kings may become your master. And that's when you're able to come to true freedom. I'll come to the end of my words. There are many people who hold on to their own standards and living their walk of faith. We too, if we do not come to the answer and the conclusion that Jesus is the Christ and we are not able to believe that, we too will live for ourselves. Yes, we can fall down and stumble over, but every time we do, we must hold on to the word of God and stand back up. Just like Peter, we can stand back up if we believe that Jesus is the Christ. God has called us the evangelists so that we can proclaim that Jesus is the Christ through all of the land.
믿음으로 고백하고 나의 삶의 주인으로 인정하면서 받아들이시길.
So accept that Jesus Christ has come as the King of all kings and make him your master.
인생의 여정에서 하나님의 은혜와 사랑이 날마다 누려지게 되는 것입니다.
And that is when you're able to enjoy the love and the grace of God inside of all of your journey. I bless you in the name of the Lord. May you have victory.
찬송하면서 말씀 붙잡고 기도하는 시간 갖기를 원합니다. 찬송 314장 내 구주 예수를 더욱 사랑 찬송하겠습니다. 기도 제목들 한번 보십시다. 하나님의 은혜와 사랑 안에 있는 전도 제자의 기도 한번 보십시다. 같이 한번 읽어볼까요? 망대 여정 이정표를 기도로 누림으로 하나님과의 교제가 깊어지게 하옵소서. 내 경험과 생각과 기준을 쫓아가는 신앙생활이 아니라 하나님의 방법, 말씀을 따라 인도받는 삶이 되게 하옵소서. 예수 그리스도가 나의 주인된 삶을 살아가게 하옵소서. 기도 제목들 여러분 마음에 담으면서 함께 찬양하겠습니다. 내 구주 예수를 더욱 사랑.
내 구주
있습니다. 하나님의 은혜와 사랑이 항상 누려져야 합니다. 바로 하나님과의 교제를 통해서 우리에게 주시는 축복입니다. 망대와 이정과 이정표를 기도로 누림으로 날마다 하나님의 은혜 그 사랑들을 항상 우리의 삶 속에 누리게 하시며 하나님을 알 수 있는 방법인 말씀 붙잡고 기도 속에서 균형한 축복의 응답을 누리게 하여 주옵시고 정말 예수 그리스도가 나의 왕됨을 고백할 수 있는 나의 주인됨의 삶을 살아갈 수 있도록 우리 생애를 축복하여 주옵소서. 그래서 정말로 하나님의 은혜가 우리 사랑 안에 우리 하나님의 은혜와 사랑이 우리 안에 넘치는 축복 가운데 날마다 우리의 삶이 전도자의 삶이 되도록 축복하여 주옵소서. 우리 같이 한 음성으로 말씀 붙잡고 기도하겠습니다. 성령하신 하나님 아버지